The first theorem of this chapter we are going to study, that is known as basic proportionality theorem. Or just we can tell BPT, basic proportionality theorem or BPT. For proving a theorem, some steps are required. First step is you have to write the statement of the theorem. Statement of the theorem. Then according to the theorem, figure we have to draw. How much figure we are able to draw by using the statement that we have to draw. Then write the given condition. Then what we have to prove you write. In some of the theorems and in almost all the theorems, we can't prove the given conditions or by using the given figures. So some extra constructions we have to draw. That is called the construction part. And then you have to write proof. So these are the different steps. So first you have to write the statement of the theorem. Then you have to draw the figure. Write given, write what we have to prove, then write if any extra construction is required that you have to write, and then you have to write the proof. These are the different steps. So basic proportionality theorem states that in a triangle, if in a triangle, a line parallel to any one side intersects other side, then the ratios will be equal. Okay. So once again I am telling what's the theorem. One triangle will be given in a triangle. So we are taking the triangle as ABC. In a triangle, if a line is drawn parallel to any one side, so I am drawing a line parallel to BC. So if a line drawn parallel to BC, so I am taking that particular line as D, intersects other two sides in distinct points. Intersects other two sides in distinct points, different points D and E. Divides other two sides in the same ratio. That is the statement of the theorem. Once again, in a triangle, so in triangle ABC, if a line, we are drawing a line DE parallel to any one side, so parallel to BC, intersects these two sides at different points, distinct points, then the sides are in equal proportion. This one, equal proportion, or the ratios will be equal. So we have to prove AD divided by BD is equal to AE divided by C. Okay. So that is the statement of the theorem. So this much figure is given. So what is given? Statement you have to write first, that I will give later. So given is what? In triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. This is given. DE is parallel to BC. Now we have to write to prove. What we have to prove? AD by BD is equal to AE by CE. This ratio equal. Okay. For proving this particular thing, suppose the given necessary figure is not sufficient, then we have to give some extra constructions. So that you have to write next, that is called construction. Okay. So here the construction is that you have to by heart. What is the construction? So here the construction is join BE and CD. This is the construction first. What? Join BE and CD. First construction. Next construction is from D, draw a perpendicular to the side AC. From D, draw a perpendicular to the side AC. So that will be like this. DM will be perpendicular to AC. Now you see, if DM is perpendicular to AC, then DM is perpendicular to AE also. Why? Because if you get a line and if you get an external point P, from P we can draw infinite number of lines, but only one line will be perpendicular. Only one will be perpendicular. These are not perpendiculars. So if we consider this part, this line, D is an external point. From D, only one perpendicular will be there to the particular side. Okay. Similarly, draw EN perpendicular to AB. EN perpendicular to AB. Then EN will be perpendicular to AD also. So what is the next construction? Draw DM perpendicular to AC and EN perpendicular to A. So given two pro construction over. Now we are doing the proof part. So proof part contains two types. Left side you write the statement and corresponding to the right side you write the reason. Left side write the statement, right side write the reason. So that reason you can write in bracket also. Okay. So we are starting the proof. For doing this, first we are considering triangle ADE. This is the upper triangle. See, triangle ADE, and we are considering triangle ADE, and we are considering triangle BDE. So position you see, which is two triangle? Triangle ADE upper, and this left triangle, triangle BDE, this we are considering. So I am writing like this: triangle ADE and triangle BDE. Its area we are considering. Its area. What is the area of any triangle? Area of any triangle formula, half BH. Okay. So if we consider triangle ADE, this is the perpendicular. So what will be the base? Base is AD and height is EN. So we can write half into base is AD and height is EN divided by area of triangle BDE, this left triangle, there we are considering the base BD. So half into base BD into what I told, see, AD, BD, AB, everything lying on the same line. AD, BD, AB, everything lying on the same line. So from the external point E, there will be only one perpendicular to the particular line. That is what? EN. So that perpendicular is EN. Now you see, half and half we can cut. EN and EN we can cut. we are getting AD by BD. Take it as 1. Again, we are considering the top triangle ADE. Same triangle we are considering. Triangle ADE. And this right part, which part you see? CED. This part. For the first case, BDE. Now, CED. This one. So, area of triangle CED. There, here, in first case, we consider this AD as the base. Now, in second case, we are considering AE as base. When AE is the base, this is the D. DM is the height. See? AE, base, which is the height? DM. So, we can write half into AE into DM divided by half into. Now, for the second triangle, considering this as the base, what is the height? Same DM is the height. Why? Because AE, CE and AC all are lying on the same line. So, half into CE into DM. Half, half cut, DM, DM cut. We are getting AE by CE. It is equation 2. So, what we have to prove, you see, AD by BD is equal to AE by CE. That we have to prove. So, for proving these two equal, it is enough to prove that these two LHS equal. For proving RHS 2 equal, it is enough to prove LHS 2 equal. So, this one, this we are going to prove equal. See, here area of triangle ADE, area of triangle ADE, this top equal. But, now we are considering this point, this two, BDE and CED. BDE and CDE. BDE, this one, CDE, this one. Okay. In 9th class you studied one result. If two parallel lines are there, then if we draw a triangle like this, this is the base. The third vertex is lying on the parallel line. From here we can draw another triangle. 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 But what is the result? The areas of all these triangles are equal. So what is the result you studied? You just to remember, areas of triangles on the same base and between the same parallels are equal. What result you studied? Areas of triangles on the same base and between the same parallels are equal. So now you see this triangle DE is the base. Vertex is lying here. For this triangle, again DE we can consider as the base. And vertex is lying here. But these two are parallel lines according to the given condition. These two. So, triangles on the same base, D, and between the same parallels are equal in area. So, what we got? These denominators are also equal. So, numerators already equal, denominators equal. So, what we will get? This is equal to this. When LHS is equal to L, LHSs are equal, so RHS also equal. So what we will get? AD by BD is equal to AE by CE. Okay, so this proof you have to by heart and write 2-3 times and study. Figure given to prove, construction, proof, even statement also. This is called a basic proportionality theorem.